Hello guys, and welcome back to another video from my YouTube channel, that is Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. And this particular video we are going to talk about osmosis in detail. So what do you know about osmosis? Osmosis kya hota hai? It is the phenomena of transfer or the movement of solvent molecules, or we can say water because it is a universal solvent, from its high concentration to its low concentration. This is the most simplest definition of osmosis. From high chemical potential or from high water potential to the low water potential, when water moves under a gradient, that is known as osmosis, but through a semi-permeable membrane. There is always a semi-permeable membrane, that is known as SPM, present between the two chambers, separating those two chambers jahan se water ki movement hogi. Firstly, let's take an overview of the whole cell. Okay, this is the outer cell wall. We know that very well. This is outer cell wall. Inside it, we have a cell membrane, or we can call it as plasma membrane. And inside it, we have a very large vacuole. Okay, this is vacuole. And what is the outer membrane of vacuole called? It is Tonoplast. So this is the structure of a typical cell. We are just talking about membranes here. That's why we have not made all the cell organelles, right? So this is the cell wall. Inside it, we have a plasma membrane or cell membrane. And inside it, we have a large vacuole, which is surrounded by tonoplast. So inside vacuole, there are more concentration of different kind of things, because it contains food, which is known as vacuolar sap. Therefore, it is having a very large concentration. Ab iski concentration kafi large hai, it means it is having a very large amount of solute. That's why the most contribution to the solute potential is given by vacuole. This is quite common in cells. Agar lagaya jaye to, there is a vacuole and it is containing all the food particles. So obviously it is having a large solute concentration. It means that the solute potential created by this particular vacuolar sap is largest. Okay, it contributes to the solute potential. After that, in cell we know very well that the protoplasm contains a lot of water. The outer cell wall is permeable in nature. Permeable. What is permeable? Permeable means that it permits the entry of solute as well as solvent. So the outer membrane, or we can say the outer cell wall, does not provide any kind of restrictions. Wo koi rok tok nahi lagata, any solvent, any solute can pass through this cell wall because it is quite permeable. But the tonoplast as well as the plasma membrane gives restriction, because these are not permeable. These are selectively permeable membranes. Or we can consider them semi-permeable membranes, because they give the entry to only selected solutes as well as solvents. So they are quite selective in nature. Okay. So these membranes provides restrictions. Restrictions in the movement of solute as well as solvent. So if some solvent or solute have to pass through the cell wall, it can pass easily because that wall is permeable. But when it have to cross plasma membrane or vacuolar tonoplast, then it cannot pass through it easily because these provide restrictions. So they affect the entry of solute as well as solvent to a greater extent, right? Because these are creating restrictions. That's why kisi cheez ka in dono ke through pass hona kafi zyada important hai, aur wahi jo hai determine karte hain kisi particular solute or solvent ki concentration inside the cell. Because these are the only two membranes which provide restrictions, and these are selective in nature. That's why they determine the concentration of solute and solvent inside the cell. Okay, so I hope that all of you have heard about osmometer. You have done an experiment in 11th or 12th class, even in 10th class, about potato osmometer. I will brief you about that particular experiment. There is a potato, okay, and we just used to make a cavity inside it. Okay, so that it behaves like a very thin membrane, and then we used to fill fresh water in that. Okay, and after that we do have water all around it. And then we used to fill the sucrose solution. Here the solution is sucrose. Sucrose have high solute content because it is having a very large concentration, right? So we will put a pin over here to mark the concentration of sucrose. After that, this particular thing is having pure water. Pure water means large number of water molecules. It means that this is having high water potential. In this particular portion, there is high concentration of sugar. It means that there is low concentration of water. It means that low water potential. And the water moves from high water potential to the low water potential through a membrane. So when the water will pass through high content to the low content, this sucrose solution will rise because the water is also entering, right? So it will rise, and then we would mark that particular marking with some another pin to understand that the level has risen and what is the reason behind that particular rise, that is osmosis. Because due to that phenomena, the water has entered through a semi-permeable membrane inside the more concentrated solution, and that's why level jo hai badh gaya. Ye particular experiment hai, this is the most simplest experiment by which we can determine that osmosis has taken place. This is known as potato osmometer experiment. This is quite simple to understand. Now, in your book, another experiment is given. What is that experiment? That is thistle funnel experiment. This is thistle funnel, okay? Thistle funnel. This one is the thistle funnel. So what is the making of thistle funnel? The thistle funnel is closed, right? And this particular end have a membrane. Okay, we used to put a membrane over here, and that membrane is usually egg membrane. How to make an egg membrane? Egg membrane kaise bana sakte hum? Just take an egg. Okay, if this is an egg, just take it. Just make a pore inside it. Okay? And remove all the contents, remove yolk and remove albumin protein, remove all the contents from it. You just get a shell. Okay, after getting that shell, put this particular egg in dilute HCl, in dilute acid. Okay, in dilute HCl acid for some hours. After some hours, you will get a membrane. This particular shell will degrade and you will get a thin membrane intact. That membrane is known as egg membrane because it is derived from egg. So this is the procedure by which you can get an egg membrane which is semi-permeable in nature. You can bind that particular membrane to the thistle funnel. This is the egg membrane. This black one is the egg membrane. Okay. Now you have filled the sucrose solution inside it. This is same as potato osmometer. You have filled the sucrose solution inside it. Now the concentration of sucrose solution is quite large. You know that very well, because it is having less water content. So charo aur kya hai? Water hai. This is water and this is sucrose. So obviously the water will have a tendency to flow from high water potential to low water potential, okay, through a semi permeable membrane. So this is the moment of solvent or the moment of water from high chemical potential, or in case of water we can say high water potential, to the low water potential. This is known as osmosis because it is taking place via a semi-permeable membrane. So after that, the water will enter into the sucrose solution and the level of sucrose solution will rise, as in this case, which will indicate that there is absorption of some water or there is transfer of some water content, which simply means that osmosis is taking place. So this is also a confirmatory experiment to prove that osmosis occur, okay, from high water potential to low water potential through a semi-permeable membrane. So now, if we want to stop the movement of water, then what can we do? We used to apply pressure over here, okay? We can apply external pressure, and that pressure created will stop the flow of water, because water is going upward and it is raising the level. If we can apply some pressure, then it will not let water to enter into this particular solution and to raise the level. Water upar jane ki koshish karega, hum usse daba denge from mechanical pressure. It simply means that we are stopping osmosis, and that's how we can stop the rate of osmosis and the pressure that is applied to stop the movement of water molecules from high water potential to low water potential is known as osmotic pressure. Okay, the pressure that we apply, we don't want water to show osmosis in this particular case, so we will apply some pressure over there, and that pressure, the quantity of that pressure is known as osmotic pressure. This is the correct definition of osmosis and osmotic pressure. Okay, after that let's take an example over here. Okay, in this particular beaker there are two partitions. Okay, one is this, and they are separated by semi-permeable membrane. Okay, now you can easily understand semi-permeable membrane. It can only allow the motion of solvent or the motion of water. So this is semi-permeable membrane. In this partition, the red dots are solute and the blue ones are water. It means that this portion is having high water concentration, or we can say high chemical potential of water, or high water concentration as well as high water potential. हम सब बात कर चुके हैं in the last lecture. अगर आपको नहीं कुछ water potential के बारे में पता, then you can go into the playlist and you can check it out. So this is partition A, this is partition B. It is having high water potential, it is having low water potential. So the motion will take place from high water potential to the low water potential up to equilibrium condition. Okay, at a particular condition जहां पर equilibrium आ जाएगा, जहां पर solvent molecules दोनों जगह बराबर हो जाएंगे, concentration दोनों जगह बराबर हो जाएगी, वहां पर this particular process will stop. So this particular process works in a gradient, in the presence of some gradient. And what is that gradient? That is chemical potential. Okay, so it goes from high chemical potential to low chemical potential, or in case of water we can say that high water potential to low water potential, and we can say that concentration and pressure gradient is also there. We can change this particular condition into concentration and pressure terms. Concentration bhi ho sakti hai because there is high concentration of water. So from high water concentration to low water concentration, and obviously high water molecules, large number of water molecules are creating some pressure. So we can say that high pressure to low pressure, that is quite common. And we have already talked about this, about water potential, about the pressure that a particular molecule creates, and the concentration of different kind of molecules. So this is the basics of osmosis. Now we have talked about osmotic pressure. So the osmotic pressure and the osmotic potential have the same value, have same magnitude, but their signs are just opposite. Okay, osmotic pressure is positive. Why it is positive? This is very common to understand, because we are applying some pressure, right? So the applied pressure is positive in nature. It means that osmotic pressure is positive, and osmotic potential has the same magnitude as osmotic pressure, but it has opposite sign. It means that the osmotic potential is negative. If you would be given in a particular question the osmotic potential, then you can easily calculate the osmotic pressure. Okay, so that's why you can use this particular relation in a very good manner. So you have to mark it down. After that, there is a thing that the osmotic pressure that we apply is a function of solute concentration. What do this particular statement mean? It means that higher is the solute concentration, higher will be the osmotic pressure. Because more is the solute concentration, more will be the entry of water. More will be the entry of water means the water is creating a high pressure upward. So we have to create a high pressure downward. And how you can memorize it? अगर आप पढ़ेंगे 12th class का second chapter of chemistry that is known as solutions, then you will find a relation that pi is equal to CST, where pi is the osmotic pressure, T is the temperature, and C is the concentration. So from this particular relation we can derive that pi is directly proportional to C. It means that osmotic pressure is directly proportional to concentration. और यहां पर हम वही बात कर रहे हैं in a theoretical manner, right? So this is about osmosis. So you have to memorize some things, that is the movement of water from one place to the other place. किस किस चीज के influence में हो सकता है? Second thing is the relation between osmotic pressure and osmotic potential. And the third most important thing is that the solute concentration. It means that the osmotic pressure totally depends upon the concentration of solute, and you can determine this particular thing practically by this formula. So I hope ki aapko aaj ka lecture samajh mein aaya hoga. Agar aapko a particular concept samajh mein aaya which is very important from examination point of view, then do hit like button. And if you are watching my video for the very first time and you found it beneficial, to apne doston ko mere channel ke bare mein zarur bataiye, meri video unke sath share kijiye aur mere channel ko subscribe kijiye, and stay tuned for the upcoming videos on transport in plants. Thank you.